you know, it was depressing. I think we had more deposits than StanChat. We wrote a blog back like 3 years ago, StanChat had about 1.5 times our deposits. So we seem to be doing something good for the customer on the deposit side. But as Kule is saying, I think there's sort of embedded cost in our business, and this year particularly has been very challenging. And I think those macros that Kule showed are very instructive. And for all of us as bankers, let's understand those macros and how they impact our business and therefore our behaviors. But please do ask questions to my partner. We've all lost care in the last 12 months. But I think all of this hinges on us as Standard Bank or part of the Standard Bank Group. And this year, the group has generally been repositioning the bank. And we are a very integral part of the bank. Myself and Kwamina Nana spent some time about a month ago with our colleagues, with Sim and Ben, to look at how they want us as a group to proceed. And as we look at these numbers, which is really reflecting 2015, moving into 2016 and beyond, I think it's important that we immerse ourselves in where the group is going and then go back into our various business units to understand how we will, you know, play together our role with the rest of Africa to achieve the group objectives. So as I said, there's been a lot of work ongoing at a group level to reposition Standard Bank. And what I want to share with you is really what Sim and Ben, because they're the joint CEOs. You know Sim and Ben, right? I think fortunately for us in Ghana, both of them have visited us a number of times in the last 3 years. Who doesn't know Sim? Or Ben? I think Sim was here sometime this year. Right, so they met all the group execs to position the Standard Bank strategy. So still their thunder is from the roots up and very basic. I'll let the video run and I'll
as an organization, we have a very clearly defined purpose. Africa is our own. We drive the growth. But what does that mean? How does Standard Bank drive the growth of the continent? Well, we provide products and services that are relevant and appropriate to our various markets in support of their economic development. That is what most financial institutions would tell you if you ask them that question. And whilst that may be true, we are a bit more than that. We are an integral part of the societies in which we operate. As one of the long-standing pillars of the business community, we have always understood this. As an African financial institution, working to serve the people of the continent, we value enduring relationships, mutual obligations, and strong communities. We help people to become active economic agents. We make it possible for young people to invest in their future by accessing student loans. We empower families to buy homes. We enable people to plan and provide for their retirement years. In the Nelson Mandela Metro in South Africa, we have funded the installation of more than 110,000 solar water heaters in low-income housing developments. We continue to be the African leader in mining finance. And every mining deal we facilitate stimulates much more infrastructure development, as roads, ports, and railways are developed to maximize the value of investment. We are also Africa's market leader in financing sustainable, low-carbon development. We contribute directly to industrialization and job creation, right across the economic scale, from loans and enterprise development support for African small-scale farmers and businesses to large-scale corporate deals. For all these reasons and more, our existence cannot just be focused on a bottom line. We continually strive to ensure that we are a valuable member of the communities and societies in which we operate, now and into the future. To do that, we have to be prepared for anything. We have to anticipate what's to come, willing to push beyond boundaries, to be curious, to be innovative, to always see and do more, to never stop moving forward.
Jesus was foretold, wasn't it? Jesus was foretold. We're told the star would appear, isn't it? We're given signs that Jesus would appear. Why do you think God did that? It's legitimacy. But if somebody just got up and said some miracle baby was born in some major somewhere, would you take it serious? You wouldn't. But the exact signs you see before Jesus came were told up front. So when he came and those signs were ticked off, nobody doubted that that was a Christ. Isn't it? That's legitimacy. So for you to do anything, there must be. If you're told that you're a lawyer, you can't just walk here with a well-dressed, funny white hair, and say you're a lawyer. No, you have to have legitimacy. And when you see all these big graduations of doctors, lawyers, and university, it's nothing other than to give you legitimacy for people to say you're qualified to do what you're doing. So whatever we talked about as legitimacy, you heard Sim and Ben say, we have a very, very proud history. We've been in Africa for 150 plus years. If you just imagine Ghana, 60 years ago? It's a bush, it was a colonial colony. But we've been here twice the age of Ghana as an independent country. Don't we have legitimacy? Do we not have legitimacy? We do have legitimacy. So if we say that we are for Africa, in and across Africa, for Africa, we mean what we say. No, not too many financial institutions can boast of that. So for us, if we say that I started buying, even though we are 50, 60 years old in Ghana, it doesn't matter. We can actually say we are 150 years old on Africa. That's legitimacy. Now, once you have a clear purpose, and Jesus' purpose was clear, he was coming to redeem your purpose, and legitimacy was established. So now we come to the how and the what. And the how and the what, if you all have been part of this group, and you're aware that if we run ourselves at PBB and CIB, I don't think you quite understand the drive back to the point Sim made very strongly. We are one bank. I don't think if you operate in Ghana, you understand it more like those who operate in other countries. That in other countries, CIB and PBB could almost be regarded as different banks. They live their lives without even literally speaking to each other as professionals, much more care about the same clients. You understand? In Ghana, we don't have that depth of siloed mentality. But Ghana is not a group. So what this strong sentence, we are one bank, is to say, we are one bank, we will sit around our customer. We will take a big multinational CIB client and understand that that one multinational CIB client also has retail opportunities, has wealth opportunities, has trade requirements, has whatever you can think about. Everything we offer in this bank is focused on that customer. That is the one bank. And then we're going to deliver it. What word did he use? Seamless. So I think underline these words. And if you know, I think I participated in about two or three different conferences building up to this new group statement. And everybody needs it. So you will see, as we continue to roll, that we will continue. Because the customers still need us to focus on their particular needs. And let's ensure that the customer is feeding us as one bank. We would see, for example, when we go to the last slide, the strategy. The strategy on one page, that slide. for us, the values is given. That's the, those eight values would drive our thought. All of us are supposed to live by the values, isn't it? Is anybody exempted from living the values? No. And if you all live those values, that mountain may just become our culture. So I'd just like to share this. This is the entire strategy. Everything that Sim and Ben said is on this page. And everything that Pamela will be sharing with you in the CIPA presentation is on this page. Everything that I will be telling you is on this page. If Fule is presenting to finance, it's on this page. If Doris is presenting to us, it's on this page. So recognize the roles and then the calls. The first one is the purpose. Africa is our home, we drive and growth. It is the purpose CIB. Do you see CIB there? Africa is our home, we drive and growth. Do you see CIB there? So this is the one band purpose. The other one is our legitimacy. We all came from the same roots. CIB wasn't born out as a mental customer. This is our history. We've got to strive to achieve that. And our presence in Africa, and of course we are, because we got to understand the rest of the world, but we do so on a tactical basis. And the pioneering spirit. So for those of us on the cutting edge, especially in the CIB in the emerging market, we come to have a primary spirit. Can you imagine what our forebears are 150 years ago confronted with? They didn't have all those risk analytical tools that we have today. But they ran back in this, and that's so much of that. And you can see that the commercial pragmatism. You know, you see a customer and you say, look, the guy says I don't have security. Can't even have a conversation. That's not commercial pragmatism. So again, I'm sure as the punchline has come, the meaning of things like commercial pragmatism and how it comes true all the way to decisions you take as say legal or operations or audit, all of that. How commercially pragmatic do you think? I have an example, but where you today have examples from. Again, if we look at our vision, see the vision? Again, it's a straight line across. I want to take note of those that carry all of us on top. Our vision. What the leading financial services organization in, for, and across Africa, delivering exceptional client experiences and superior value. Again, that runs across. And this is enforced by values. See the values right across again. So all those three, those four, we carry it. And again, the principle, we heard simply the word, what is the impression? Okay, I'll stay. But we'll go out.